Welcome back to the channel, guys. My name is Aryan, and I bought a Tesla. So it's been a goal of mine for a very, very long time. And this summer, I decided to pull the trigger on a Tesla Model 3 long range in all black. So in this video, I want to talk about my Tesla order experience because I actually went through the existing inventory section and we're going to be talking a lot about that in this video. And also, I want to give you guys some tips on how to save money when you're buying a Tesla and answer some of the questions that I had that I wish I had answers to during my whole order experience to help you guys out. So before we start, do me a solid and hit that subscribe button and let's just jump right into it. Let's start with what I think is probably the most useful tips, and that's how to save money when you're ordering your Tesla. Now there's a few simple ways and there's a few complex ways that you can save money, but I'm gonna be going through what I did to save a couple thousand dollars when I ordered my Tesla. So the Tesla referral program, I'm gonna have my linked down below. And basically with that, you can click it, order your Tesla like you would just regularly, and you're gonna save a few hundred dollars as well as get free self-driving for 3 months on your Tesla. When I ordered my Tesla, I used a referral link and I got $650 Canadian off of my car, which is quite a substantial amount literally for just clicking a button. On top of that, I also got 3 months of full self-driving. I didn't equip my car with full self-driving because in Canada that's like 13 grand or something like that, and I had no use for that. With the referral link, I got 3 months for free, so I take it. So like I said, basically all you have to do, and I'm gonna have mine linked in the description, is just click the link when you're ordering it, order your Tesla as you would, and then when you see your price breakdown, for example, if you're in Canada, I got $650 off my car, substantial amount. And what I actually did was I saved the referral link into my notes, so when I was actually ready to place the order, I had it ready, clicked on it, ordered it, saved money. Government EV incentives. Now, depending on where you live, your government might offer you some rebates or some incentives for driving an EV. Now, here in Ontario, in Canada, it's not the greatest program, but it's something. I got $5,000 off the price of my Tesla, as well as I can use like the HOV lanes. So again, this is like very, very simple because the Tesla already qualifies for that $5,000 in Ontario. So it was just automatically taken off the price of the car. I didn't have to apply for it. I didn't have to do anything. It was automatic, very, very seamless. I don't even have to think about it. So depending on where you live, whatever province or state, you might have substantial amount of savings just based on the EV incentives. Now, existing inventory. I want to make this clear that existing inventory does not mean used. I ordered mine off the existing inventory page on the Tesla website, and it was a brand new car. Tesla has its own section for used inventory and existing inventory. So on the existing inventory page, you can get a brand new car. I saved like $4,000 additional just by going through existing inventory. But you can also get a demo car. So these are basically the cars that like people take on test drives and whatnot. So yeah, they are a little bit more used. They still classify as existing inventory for some reason. I don't really know why or how, but you can save even more on those cars too. So if you're looking to save like a few thousand dollars, definitely look into existing inventory. That's what I did, and I am like very, very happy. I had no quality and control issues. I had no issues at all. I got a brand new car and I saved like $4,000. The order process. Now this is a very, very simple process, so I'm just gonna get right through it. So the first thing I actually did was I scheduled a test drive for the Tesla. I scheduled it for later on. I scheduled it for like 6 p.m. And actually when I got there, they just told me, hey, do you want the car overnight? And I was like, can I take the car overnight? And they're like, yeah. I'm like, is it free? They're like, yeah, it's free. So I had the car overnight, dropped it back 11 a.m. So it really gave me a chance to get used to the car, to experience the car. And I didn't have like any salesperson from the dealership sitting with me. I could do whatever I wanted. Now the car was limited to 137 kilometers per hour, but I'm not going over that anyways. So that's definitely something I recommend, is scheduling a test drive for your Tesla. So I told them I wanted to go through the used inventory section. They said no problem. And I made a Tesla account when I was over there, and I used my referral link to get the $650 off. And basically, just like that, I ordered a Tesla the same way that I would order a regular Tesla when I was at home. But here's where it gets just a little bit different. Now with the used inventory, they actually told me exactly the dates that the car was supposed to come in, because on the website, it just said coming soon. So he told me, okay, the car is supposed to come in September 3rd. We're gonna need a few days and you could pick it up. And basically right then and there, I said, okay, September 3rd, that works for me. Now, can I be assigned to that car? Because they have the VIN numbers like in the back, like on their computer, they were showing me. So basically they assigned me a VIN for the existing inventory right then and there. but the VIN actually doesn't show up in your Tesla account until like much, much later. But still, like, I was locked in for the car that was coming on September 3rd. So after that, now you're on your Tesla account and you have to fill in your registration, your payment information, whether you're paying it in cash, whether you're leasing it, or whether you're financing it. And then you have to submit like proof of insurance before delivery. And all of that was very, very simple. And now you're just playing the waiting game, which in my opinion is probably the worst part, because you're just anxiously checking the app, checking how long it's gonna be, and you're excited for your new car, so it feels like forever. So like I said, they assigned me a VIN when I was at the dealership, but it never showed up in my account until I actually got the email notification that I can schedule delivery. When I got the VIN, then I could actually take it to my insurance, get the insurance, and then submit the proof of insurance on the Tesla website. Now, another thing to note, and I don't know if it's just because I'm here in Canada, but when I was watching a bunch of YouTube videos, it says that you can do all of this, like registration, insurance, all this stuff through the app. It didn't let me on my app. So all that was showing on my app was basically the estimated delivery date. It gave me like a time window, as well as the model that I ordered. Again, I don't know if it's just a Canadian thing, but I thought I'd mention it. But it, regardless, I could just go on the website. It doesn't change anything. And it just gave me a button that says go to account. And then it just linked me to the website where I could do the registration and all that. So again, something I thought I'd mention, but, and honestly, it didn't really change anything. So now let's fast forward to the delivery day. So I got the email notification that sends me basically a bunch of days where I can accept delivery, and then I can select the time slot that works for me. And when you're there, you need your driver's license, and you have already needed to upload your proof of insurance. Now, I paid for the car through my personal bank, not through Tesla financing, so I selected the cash option. So basically, I had the payment and everything all confirmed the night before that I actually had to take delivery. So when I got there, basically I got to the dealership, I went to the Tesla delivery section, and they said, okay, I gotta sign a few documents. I went to the car, did a full inspection, came back, signed off the car, took the keys, left. It was very, very simple. I think I was there for probably like 20 minutes, and of those 20 minutes, 15 of them were just spent inspecting the car, which I do recommend, because I've seen it all on YouTube. Like, inspecting the car, especially with Tesla, is just a good idea because they're known for some quality issues and you just don't want to go through that, so just inspect the car. And honestly, guys, like, that's it. That was my whole Tesla delivery process, from when I test drove the car to when I picked up the car. I'm gonna be making a lot more videos involving the car, and if you guys have any questions or some things you want to see, make sure you drop it off in the comments, because I'm gonna be looking through those and I'm gonna be making a lot more videos based on what you guys want to see. So again, if you're in a situation where you're interested in ordering a Tesla, make sure you use my referral code. It's going to be linked down in the description, and you can save yourself a few $100, as well as make sure you subscribe to the channel for a lot more content. Thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Aryan, and I'm going to see you guys in the next video.